Whatever you are designing, you need images to represent what you're trying to portray in your designs. And especially if the client's budget is tight and if you are just starting out, you want to use free images as much as possible, but you don't want to use just any free images. You want to use high quality images which are created with a purpose and they will look good in your designs, and most important of all, they are going to represent what you're trying to show in your design better than those free stocks that you find on Google and you don't even know if the license is covering it. If they don't have the license, is somebody is going to sue you later, and so on. In this video, I'm going to show you a few different resources of free images that you can use in your designs. They are all really high quality and I really recommend that you use them because it will make your designs look more polished and more professional when you use these free images. So to get started, maybe most well-known resource is unsplash.com. Now, all of these images are free for you to use in both personal and commercial work. You can license back to the photographer if you want to, but that's something that is an option for you, not a requirement. You can read more about their licenses, but basically you can use them free of charge without any recognition to the original photographer, and you can use them in both personal and commercial work. So if you scroll down, you can see how they look like. So they are really high quality. You can sort them out by categories and you can even type right here. So if I type car, for example, it will show me various different cars and these extended tags right here. So for the brands of cars. If you want to download any of these images from Unsplash, you can simply click right here and you can collect it. And you can add it to your collection, which is really important, especially if you're sending these images to developers. So you can create your free account right here on Unsplash and you can collect these images, add them to your collections, and then simply when you're finished with them, you can send the link to the collection to the developers and they can use them in a high resolution if that's something that they want. Or you can simply navigate back to the collection, download all of these images in the biggest possible size, and then send that zip file back to the developers if that's something that they require. If you want to download this image, you can do it from here. So if you are using Google Chrome like I do, you can simply right click, copy image, and then paste it directly into your XD, or you can simply download for free right here and it will show you this prompt at the bottom. So crediting isn't required, but it is appreciated and allows photographers to gain exposure. You can copy the text below or embed a credit badge to your website. So you can simply hit copy right here and it will copy this text and you can send that back to your client, and if they want, they can show it on their website, or if you're using this for your blog, for example, it's nice if you want to credit it. But as I said, it isn't required, but it's just a goodwill if that's something that you want to do. Next resource is Pixabay. So it's basically the same as Unsplash, but on Pixabay you have to create an account in order for you to download images. You can download them from here. So for example, if I click this image, I can simply copy the image, but it will download it in really small size. If you want to get the biggest possible size for this particular image, for example, you have to log in and you have to sign up for the free account, and then you will be able to download it in the biggest possible size. You can also create collections right here. You can like images, you can follow people if you like their images, and every time that they upload, you will get a notification and you can then simply jump back and explore their images. You can even leave comments right here if you want to. And all of these websites are making money. You can see that MailChimp is sponsoring the Unsplash and Adobe Stock is sponsoring Pixabay, or this is simply an affiliate link on their site, and when you click right here, they will get the commission. So that's how these websites are making money. But images are free and you can simply upload your own images if you want to share them with the world, and that's how these photography communities are born on these websites. Next up we have Pexels, which is basically the same as Pixabay, and Pexels is a bit different because they are collecting images from different websites and their own. So if I scroll a bit down, you can see that these are the users who uploaded these images. But if I scroll even more down, we are going to find some, as you can see, which are uploaded by these other brands. So you can see images from Unsplash right here or from Pixabay, especially videos, because sometimes they upload these really nice videos and you can use them in your work, obviously for free. But in those videos, you can see that they are uploaded by, for example, Pixabay or Unsplash or some of these other websites. And they are trying, by doing that, they are trying to attract you as a visitor, for example, back to Pixabay or back to Unsplash. So all of these different websites are sharing the traffic between each other. Next resource is burst.shopify.com, and that name really should ring a bell, because Shopify is this online platform where you can purchase a website similar to WordPress if you have a business, and you can set up that business. So for example, if you're selling anything online, you can go to Shopify and buy the website basically, and you can create it and rearrange it to fit your needs, and you can add as many functionalities to it as you want. Basically, you're paying them once a month or once a year, and you can sell and have your own business via your own website using Shopify. But they have this burst.shopify.com images collection, and they are geared more towards small businesses and entrepreneurs. So for example, if you want to use some of these images in your business, you can see, so if you're running coffee shop business, for example, you can click on this collection and you can use some of these images. They're really high quality, and you can see that there are a lot of people in these images, because that will bring a humane side to your business rather than just using cups and mugs and just standing coffee like this. You can see that, for example, if you sell jewelry online, you can click right here and you can see how all of these images look like, and they are even giving you some tips and tricks. So this is not just an image sharing website, but they are trying to help you move your business along, and by doing that, of course, they want to sell you the Shopify, but they're really helpful in those tips, and you can really apply some of those tips, especially if you're taking your own photos for your own business. So you can see how some of these photos look like online, and you can see some tips and tricks further. And finally, I want to show you this resource, which is thestocks.im. And this resource is really huge, because you can see right here all of the premium as well as free resources on the left, and whichever one of these you click, it will take you to that website. And we just saw Burst by Shopify, and when I click right here, it will open it in a new tab. So it's giving you all of these different resources. We talked about Unsplash, so when you click right here, it will take you to Unsplash, and you can explore some of these directly through this website. So you can see this website, you can, without leaving the stocks.im, you can download these images and videos. Finally, you can see right here that we selected photos. You can select colors, and it will load the palette table, so you can select some different colors. You can see some icons, but it's loading the Shutterstock, so that's not free, you have to pay for it. If you click videos, it's going to load motion elements, and if you want to use these mockups, you can see that you can use them as well, and it's loading Type Wolf, so you can see some font pairings and so on. So it's really a nice resource if you want to use the free images, and you can find free colors, free fonts, free icons, and so on, all within this one website, so you don't have to browse through all of them. But if you want to, or if you like a certain style from one of these websites, so for example, you like this Unsplash style of images, you can use just Unsplash if you want to. In the next video, we're going to talk about icons and where you can get free icons, so I'll see you there.